Hey y'all. The script started out as a case study of a neat little party trick, mathematically figuring out what day of the week any given day was. It was first discovered by two men, Martin Gardner and John Conway. If you're at all familiar with mathematics, those two names might be familiar to you. And I promise you, I'll talk about it. But in the process of writing this script, a global pandemic appeared, and Conway died. This episode is about Doomsday, John Conway's Doomsday. So I must dedicate it to one of the greatest modern mathematicians. And I hope that by teaching you the method, which to be honest is simple enough that a third grader could do it, we can help to keep John Conway's work alive. We need to start from the beginning, like the very beginning. Okay, maybe not that far back. Although I guess I should establish here that, like, time exists. Our story starts in ancient Egypt. So ancient Egyptians used sundials to track time, mostly, but they also had a 360-day calendar. Then, the Babylonians stole and slightly altered the Egyptian calendar. Then, the Greeks stole and slightly altered that. Then, the Romans stole and slightly altered that. Many calendars at this point are what's called lunisolar, meaning that they designate a year, or a completed calendar cycle, as a revolution around the sun, and a month as just a completed lunar cycle. This doesn't help very much, because these two cycles don't match up perfectly, meaning that even back here, calendars have leap days, or sometimes even leap weeks, or leap months in order to make their calendars work. Time is weird, I guess. Probably because it's old. So Julius Caesar came into this whole calendar business and went, well, all of you are idiots, and the system needs to be fixed. He took the traditional Roman calendar, which was actually bonkers, probably because it didn't work very well. It was still 12 months, Januarius, Februarius, Martius, Aprilis, Maius, Junius, Quintilis, Sextilis, September, October, November, December, with months either 29 days, 31 days, and then February was either 28 or 23 with a 13th month of 22 or 23 days between February and March. They had to do this because their regular year was like only 355 days. I don't know, man, the Romans are whack. So Caesar comes along and decides this is dumb, because it is, and changes the rules to look mostly like what we have today, with months either 31 days, 30 days, or 28 or 29 days if it's February. Caesar also established a leap year every 4 years to maintain the calendar shift. Oh, also, when he died, they renamed Quintilis to Julius. Then when Augustus Caesar died as the first Roman emperor, they renamed Sextilis as well to Augustus. So that's where the months come, if you didn't know. Could have been a lot worse, actually. A lot of other Roman emperors tried to name other months after themselves, because, you know, Roman emperors are egotistical maniacs, but luckily none of those stuck. So, as you may have noticed, the Romans conquered practically all of Europe, so everyone there uses the Julian calendar. And everything has been going swimmingly since Caesar changed the calendar. Just kidding, of course it hasn't, but the calendar actually has mostly been fine. But the church, being the church, has a problem with it. Over these 1600 years, the calendar has slowly shifted. October 4th should actually be October 14th, we're 10 days off. This is actually a problem, because Easter is a holiday that is very important to the Catholic religion, and is also a holiday that doesn't have a fixed date. So trying to keep it in line with the calendar is kind of tricky. As a result, in 1582, Pope Gregory XIII looked at his options and eventually settled on one, changing the leap year. Instead of having 100 leap years in 400 years, a more accurate measurement of the year decided that we need 97 leap years every 400 years. So Gregory decreed the following. Every year that is exactly divisible by 4 is a leap year, except for years that are exactly divisible by 100. But these centurial years are leap years if they are exactly divisible by 400. It's a little confusing, so here's an example. 1904 is divisible by 4, so it's a leap year. 1900 is divisible by 4 and 100, so it's not a leap year. But 2000 is divisible by 4, 100, and 400, so it is a leap year. So on Thursday, October 4th, 1582, the switch went into effect, and the next day was Friday, October 15th. Not really sure how well that went over, but I mean, we still use the Gregorian calendar now, so I guess it must have worked out alright. Yo. So in the French Revolution, extreme measures were taken to remove all forms of monarchy, and one of the things to go was the imperial unit system, introducing the world to metric. Interestingly, the French also tried to do the same with timekeeping. They broke the day into 10 hours total, with each hour having 100 minutes and each minute having 100 seconds. Then they used a system of 12 months of 30 days broken into 10-day weeks, also called décades. Naturally, since 360 days means that the calendar starts shifting, there are 5 special days called complementary days. As you might have expected, people really didn't like the system because it was dumb and stupid, and why wouldn't you just use the old one that the Roman Catholic Church uses? Unsurprisingly, it lasted only 14 years before Napoleon abolished it. Also, due to, you know, the Catholic-Protestant split and all, not everyone immediately adopted the Gregorian calendar. The Spanish, Portuguese, and French adopted it immediately. But, for example, Britain switched in 1752. My 3 favorite calendar switches are Sweden, which tried to switch gradually over 40 years by never having leap years, then went to war and forgot that they agreed to do that, and then had to restore themselves to the Julian calendar by having a February 30th one year, before finally throwing in the towel and just removing like 2 weeks from the calendar in 1753. The other 2 examples are the Russians and the Greeks, who switched in, wait for it, 1918 and 1923, probably because they were Orthodox Catholic. Religion makes people do weird things sometimes. Alright, so now I'm going to make some really obvious observations. A while ago I mentioned that the month and a year on really old calendars weren't, like, lined up. Well, there's another unit of time too, the week. The number of days in a year is 365.2422. But we can't just have a quarter of a day, that's why we have the whole leap year thing. So let's round off to 365 to be easy then. So given this, how should we divide 365 into weeks? Well, beside itself and 1, it goes into 2 numbers evenly, 73, which is hard and unruly for mathematics, and 5. A week is 7 days long, and there are 52.14 weeks in a year. It's not just religion that makes people do weird things sometimes. The moral of the story of all of this is that humans suck, and that consistency is dumb and stupid, which is why this is even remotely impressive to begin with. There's one more thing I need to mention. The days of the week repeat. Yeah, I know, shocking, but that's actually going to be important later, so please keep that in mind. So, the problem at hand is that we need to find a way to tell what day of the week it is given any given day, right? Apparently, this problem was interesting enough that a couple famous people worked on it. Leonard Euler, one of the mathematicians who seems to have named everything, and Charles Lutwidge Dodgson. You don't know who Charles Lutwidge Dodgson is? Yeah, you do. Lewis Carroll, author of Alice in Wonderland. So, getting into recent territory now, Merton Gardner is this magician, right? And long story short, he eventually finds himself a job writing a column in Scientific American called Mathematical Games. It's pretty popular. And one day, he finds Carroll's method for finding the day of the week. It's quite complicated, but it's the best thing anyone's come up with. Conway happens to be visiting, and Gardner shows him the method, and asks him to create a method simple enough to explain to his readers. And Conway, in typical Conway fashion, invents something absolutely brilliant, the Doomsday algorithm. So obviously we're not talking about the end of the world here. In this case, the Doomsday of any given year is defined as the day of the week that the last day of February falls on. This is the basis of the method. We're going to be calculating the doomsday for any given year, and then we'll use that as an anchor to figure out the exact date. Because it's hard to find a date in December using only February 28th or 29th, Conway came up with some pretty nice doomsdays for us. So, January is the only month without a good doomsday, so I just use January 3rd or January 4th if it's a leap year. February, by definition, has a doomsday on the 28th or 29th. Side note, if the doomsday is the 28th, Valentine's Day is a doomsday. For March, we just use Pi Day, 314. From here on out, it's incredibly easy. 4-4, 6-6, 8-8, 10-10, and 12-12 are all doomsdays. That's every even month. So there's April, June, August, October, and December taken care of. Then, you just have to remember 9-5 at the 7-11, and we're set. 5-9, 9-5, 7-11, and 11-7 are all doomsdays too. From chaos comes order, I guess. And just for kicks, you can throw in the 4th of July, Halloween, and the day after Christmas if you want. So now, if you have the Doomsday for any year, for instance, 2020's is a Saturday, you can use it to find any day's day of the week in that year. Cool. From here, we're going to assign the days of the week a number, starting with Sunday, which gets a 0, so we can call it Nunday. This makes Monday into one day, Tuesday as well, still Tuesday. Wednesday becomes Triples Day, which honestly isn't great. Thursday becomes Fours Day, which I guess kind of sounds like Thursday if you're British. Friday is Five Day, and Saturday, Sixter Day. Boom. This makes it super easy to add to dates. There's one more thing you need to memorize before I can fully show you how it works, and that's the century number. In order to calculate the Doomsday, we'll use the first year of the century and do a bit of adding and dividing to get it to the year we want. The century numbers are really simple though. The 1800s is 5, the 1900s is 3, the 2000s is 2, and the 2100s is 0. That's all you need to know, because the Doomsday of a century happens to cycle every 400 years. For instance, the 2700s is a 3, because 2700 minus 400 is 2300 minus 400 again gives you 1900. So let's do it. Here's how the method works. First, pick a date. I'm going to use June 3rd, 2019, pick the date that James Holzhauer lost on Jeopardy, because I know it's a Monday off the top of my head, so I can easily check it. We're going to be adding 4 numbers, so feel free to use your hand to keep track. First, start with that century number. We're in the 2000s, so our first number is 2. Then, we take the last 2 digits of the year, in this case 19, and divide it by 12. You take both the whole number answer, 1, and the remainder, 7. Then, we take that remainder and divide it by 4, taking only the whole number answer. That's the last number. In this case, it's a 1. Now, we just add them up. 2 plus 1 plus 7 plus 1 gives us 11. From here, divide by 7 and take a remainder. If you're having a problem, just remember that dividing is repeated subtraction, so you can just keep subtracting 7 too. This remainder is the Doomsday of the year. So, Doomsday in 2019 becomes a Thursday. Our date is June 3rd, and our Doomsday for June is 6-6, so we just subtract 3. 4 minus 3 is 1, so it's a Monday. That's all there is to it. I'll run through a more complicated example now. April 14th, 1865, the day Abraham Lincoln was assassinated. So, the century is 1800, so we use a 5. 65 goes into 12 5 times with a remainder of 5, and 5 divided by 4 will give us 1. So, 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 1 is 16. Divide that by 7 and take a remainder gives us a Doomsday on Tuesday. The Doomsday for April is 4-4, so we can go forward a week to 4-11 and then forward 4 more days to give us a Saturday. So, Abraham Lincoln died on a Saturday. Or, you know, you could just Google it. But what's the fun in that?